In this tutorial, we will show you how to introduce mixed particle shapes to your EDEM simulation, and how CAD templates can be assigned to your particles. First, export the simulation deck from the Rockbox, Part 1, and ensure it is at time 0 seconds. Save it as a new EDEM file. Before defining the different particle shapes, delete the existing base particle previously created in Part 1 of this tutorial. Add two new multisphere particles and name them. Next, create a polyhedral particle. Import the CAD particle templates under the rendering options. Browse to the location of your required CAD templates and select the required import parameters. For most cases, the default settings are fine for importing geometries. You can rename the template, and this is particularly recommended if you are dealing with multiple particle prototypes. To see the imported CAD template, ensure you are on the particle section within the creator tree. A wireframe of your imported template will appear in the viewer window. Select Rock Particle 1 and modify the sphere section so that they roughly fill the imported template. Next, set the size distribution to user defined and import the particle size distribution file provided. Repeat previous steps for the second multi-sphere particle. Set the size distribution to user defined for the second multi-sphere particle. You can turn the rock templates on and off. Next, for rock particle 3, apply the same user defined size distribution and select auto calculation. Ensure you have the correct particle dimensions. Next, create the particle factory. To do that, select the factory plate geometry and add a dynamic factory. In this model, all three rock particles are created with the same generation rate value. Check that the particle ratio shows an even composition. Finally, set a fixed velocity in the X direction. Next, move to the simulator. First, ensure your GPU card is compatible to run the EDEM simulation. Input the simulator settings, including the hybrid precision mode. You're now ready to start the simulation. Move to the analyst to review and analyze the simulation results. You have different options for representing the granular material. Use the controls of the viewer window to watch the simulation. You can display the granular material by using their associated CAD templates. Next, color the particles according to their velocity. You have a wide range of colors to choose from. unselect the auto update option, and set the minimum and maximum velocity values to be displayed. Repeat the same steps for rock particles 2 and 3. Modify the mass flow sensor dimensions. Instructions of how to create sensors and grid bin group can be found in part 1 of this tutorial. Next, plot a linear graph of the mass flow rate of all particles changing over time on the bottom conveyor. The graph indicates that the first particles pass through the sensor approximately 5 seconds after the simulation begins. Next, plot the graph of the total particle mass in the rock box. The bin group records the change in the total mass of the particles passing through. Finally, plot a pie chart of the percentage of each particle type in the rock box. Change the attribute to mass. The most common particles is rock particle 2, as these are the least dense of the three particle types, therefore, more particles are needed to match the specified mass flow rate.